welcome back to my channel. Today I thought I would do a video like just getting ready with me, my outfit, hair and makeup, because I'm going to be going out with my friend in a while. So I thought I would do this because I haven't done one in so long, and a big reason why is just because I don't wear a lot of makeup recently, just because like the weather is like 100 degrees outside and it melts off your face. But I thought today I would like to do some subtle kind of, I'm not gonna say subtle because I'm not very good at subtle makeup. You always know I'm wearing makeup when I'm wearing it. I kind of go full out, but a like nice glowy bronzy summer look. So yeah, I thought I would just sit down and have a nice chit chat with you all, talk a bit about like my life, Love Island, of course. Who isn't watching that? Like, I love it. This year and last year, since I'm in Texas, I've been watching it online. So yeah, Love Island. This video will probably be out after the winners episode is up. So at the moment, I think everyone just knows Jack and Danny is gonna win. If they don't win, I don't know what the hell happened, because like, they're just the best. Oh, they're so cute. But yeah, I'm gonna get into that in a while. Let's start with the makeup. We're off with the MAC Strobe Cream. It's basically like this liquid type highlight primer. A lot of them in MAC always tell me not to put it all over my face, because it like, you're meant to just like put it in the high point. But a lot of people use it as a full on primer, and that's what I use it as. And it just helps your look stay really nice and healthy and glowing, and your skin just looks amazing underneath foundation. It really does shine through so nice. So like, I don't mind being a glowy disco ball. I like having this under my foundation because my skin can get really dry, so it like keeps the moisture. So I think I'm gonna go for the Precisely My Brow Pencil by Benefit for my brows, because I haven't tried it yet. And so I just thought I would try it now. Get a little mirror for myself. So like, I don't know, lately I kind of lost the whole YouTube grind of things, but like, I'm back. I think everyone needs a bit of a break after a while, you know? So probably how I'm gonna do this video is I'm just gonna talk and then I'll speed up parts like my brows. So I'm just gonna do these now. I'm just gonna do the other one off camera to save camera time. Okay, so I'm pretty much done the brows. I really like how they came out. Like, the Benefit eyebrow pencil, I'm very impressed with. It seems to be quite good. So yeah, I'll have everything linked down below that I use in this video, by the way. And if I can find links for stuff that aren't in Ireland, I'll also try find websites that have them, so that you guys can get anything that you might like. So the next thing I'm gonna do is my eyes. So this might seem all backwards. I feel like my makeup routine can be really backwards compared to others. But like, I like doing my eyes first, because then you can wipe away if there's any fallout and you're not ruining your foundation. So just how I have always done it. I also feel like no one does their brows first, but I always do. I feel like it just starts the look off well. So on my eyes today, I'm gonna use the Jaclyn Hill palette. Love it. Very good. Yeah, so I always just start off by priming my eyelids with whatever concealer. It really doesn't matter to me. So I literally just spread it on whatever wand I have, and then I look crazy. And then I just pat that in with like a dry beauty blender. And the reason why I like using dry is because sometimes if you like use a wet beauty blender to blend it out on my eyes, my eyelids are kind of oily, so I feel like it kind of just causes a mess and it creases before I have time to dry it, or like not dry it but like set it. And I'm just gonna set my eyelids with the Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. It just does the best job, and it's actually translucent. I feel like a lot of them put too much color if it says it's translucent, but this is literally just kind of clear color, and it doesn't cause flashback, which I love, because no one wants flashback Mary.
Hi sisters.
I'm not about to do a sister scandal right now. Although I love James Charles, I feel like he gets a bad rep on YouTube sometimes, but I love him. So the next thing I'm gonna do is take this huge fluffy brush. Figure out what I'm gonna start blending into my crease. So I'm gonna just start with like a little transition color. I think I'm gonna take this one right here. Yeah, anyway, I was talking Love Island. I love Love Island. This is my second year to watch it, but I have gone back and watched, I think it was season 2. And yeah, I haven't watched it all, but that's only because I only decided to watch season 2 like the other day. So I've been keeping track of this year's and like 2 years ago, because I love it that much. Just can't get enough, you know? I feel like everyone is on the Love Island hype this year, because like last year my friends were like, what are you watching? And now they're all watching it too, so I'm like, told you you'd be addicted. So I'm just literally framing my crease with that color, and I'm gonna go onto this eye. So then when you barely have that little bit of color, I'm gonna go on to my next shade. So next I'm just gonna go in with this fluffy brush. I'm just taking a little bit of a darker shade here, start to put in that through my crease. Again, I'm not being very like detailed with the look, because like I'm using big fluffy brushes. I'm just literally blending them through the crease, a bit out. Okay, so it's getting a bit too orangey for what I want, so I'm gonna start adding in more brown colors, I think. Okay, so I'm just taking this type fluffy brush with a little like, yeah, and I'm gonna get a darker brown color, or even like this type maroon, and I'm just gonna start, actually no, I'm not gonna go that dark yet. I think I'll go with the one beside it, this shade. Other than Love Island, another series I'm gonna be watching is Orange Is the New Black, because it's finally back. I feel like they seriously take their time with bringing out new seasons though. Kind of makes me lose interest, but like, I loved it for the good few, last few seasons. I loved Orange Is New Black, so I am glad it's back, you know? Just annoying that it takes so long. So I'm literally just adding that in. Sorry if the angle changed slightly. My battery was dying, so I just changed it before I lost you. So yeah, I wanted to talk about something that I feel like a lot of people ask about, and that's like starting a YouTube channel, how to get subscribers and that kind of thing. And I'm still a very small channel of 5,000, so like I'm not huge on YouTube or anything, but like 5,000 to me is just so amazing. And I love making videos, but like I've always loved making videos, even when I had 100 subscribers, 1 subscriber, it didn't matter to me about the views. And I think that's how it should be. I feel like at the start you need to always like do it for yourself and no one else. Just upload videos, edit videos, and do it because you love doing it. Don't do it because you see someone else being really successful out of it, you know what I mean? Because like I'm still not making a lot of money from YouTube or anything like that, but it's never about that for me. Like I've took so many breaks, we all know that like I haven't been great on keeping my track on YouTube. We know that. So like I would just recommend do it because you love doing it, and if you get a career out of it, you get a career, and then if you don't, you don't, and it's not really a big deal, to get me. So I'm just gonna like I think put this like glittery rosy shade on my eyelids and see how that works out. I don't know, again this is not a tutorial, so we're just gonna do what we want here, people. Oh, that's really pretty. So yeah, I would just say do YouTube because you like making videos. Don't do it for the views or the subscribers, because you just won't have fun. You won't have fun that way. Like the amount of times I've been sick in this year or just unmotivated to do YouTube, like just it's hard, because like you're trying to feel relevant, I suppose, but like you also have to do what's best for yourself. Do the videos that you like doing as well. So yeah, that's all I'm gonna really say about that. That's kind of just the eyes. Very kind of simple. It'll all come together when my face is done. I wet my beauty blender. Oh my god, it's so dirty. We're keeping it real here, guys. Okay, so I have wet that, and now I'm gonna figure out. I think I'm gonna wear this foundation. What I love about this is it actually gives great coverage, but it also has SPF 50 in it. So it's amazing for like the Texas sun. Yeah, I just love it. So yeah, I just put two pumps on and then I kind of spread it around my face, forehead, chin, and just bounce it in. So yeah, as I was saying, I've definitely lost touch of my channel a few times. But I'm getting really back into it now just because I'm feeling good. Like when you do not feel good, you have no motivation to kind of do a channel. It's a lot easier for me to keep up my other social medias when I'm not feeling well, because like I can do like blog posts or like, you know, like on my Instagram and that kind of thing. But I feel like sitting down and filming a video is a lot of effort when you're not well. And I just bring that down to my neck because it's quite a good color for me. Looks very orangey on camera, but it's not, I swear. But I still have to blend it down my neck a bit, which, because I haven't been out in the sun a lot lately, so my tan is kind of fading. But yeah, I swear this matches a lot more than it's looking on camera. So yeah, it's not just gorgeous, that type finish. It's not like too full coverage, but it like covers your flaws. Oh my god, it's looking so orangey on camera. I swear it's not. Editing this now, it really isn't as orange and dramatic as I thought it was, so yeah, never mind. Yeah, so next I'm gonna just put on concealer. I have this one from Tarte, which is the fair concealer, but I don't use the fair one. I use it on my eyes, but I am too dark at the moment for the fair one, so I just use fair beige, which is still very highlighty, like it's still light. Like look at that. But it's very blendable and like you don't have a big white streak, don't worry, like blends out really well. And then I just used the excess for like my chin, nose and forehead, kind of my T-zone. And yeah, I'm just gonna blend that out. And you'll see like that just blends so seamlessly. That I just grab a fluffy brush. This is from Kat Von D, and I just tap some more of my Laura Mercier setting powder in. I just set everywhere that I put the concealer. Then I go to this side and I start my contour and just bronze. So today I'm gonna use my Hoola bronzer. I haven't used this in ages, oh my god. And I'll just start warming up my face. It's so gorgeous. Oh my god. I feel like I used to love Hoola, and then like I just end up trying so many different brands as I grew older. But it's an OG, I love it. It's just a great colour, I feel like. A lot of people have been asking when I'm coming home as well, and I'm going to be coming home in October hopefully. Seems pretty legit that I'm going to be coming home to Ireland, which will be amazing. And the plan after that is going to be that a lot of people are asking me like, will I be coming back to Texas? And yes, I will. I'll be traveling back every 3 months, and then when my doctor here is more comfortable, I can travel back only every 6 months, and it'll eventually lead to only traveling once a year. That'll be for the rest of my life, to get regular checkup once a year for the rest of my life. So once a year is not bad at all in my eyes. Just thought I'd also include that since there's a huge chance of me actually being able to go home in October and the histio being gone at that point, basically right now we are just figuring out our team of doctors and everything like that as well. So in a few weeks I get a checkup to see if the last area of cancer has cleared up. If it hasn't, then we'll deal with that at that point, and we'll probably up my oral chemo. Also, if it's gone by that point, I will more than likely be getting my port out in the end of September or early October. So that will also be happening. Right now we're emailing and corresponding with different doctors in Ireland who are willing to correspond with Dr. McLean when I'm home to keep him in the loop as much as possible, as I live a hopefully very healthy future. I'm always going to need oncologists and endocrinologists. Doctors at hospitals are always going to be in my life, but
If I hadn't of came to Texas, I wouldn't be in this position. So I just wanted to put this in and, you know, thank you all again for all the support. And yeah, I'm very lucky to be at this stage of, you know, just doing so well with my cancer and my health.
And then another thing everyone's asking is, oh, and by the way, I'm just going to move on to e.l.f. this little bronzer. A lot of people ask me, like, am I going to still be on chemo then, or am I going to be finishing up chemo? I'm going to be on chemo for at least another year or so, but it's not going to be IV chemo. It's going to be like tablet form. It's oral chemo that I'm on right now. And yeah, I'm going to be on that another year to help prevent the cancer from relapsing. It's just going to be like a lower dose than it is now. So I've only one area left of cancer. Can't believe it. So happy about it. Yeah, so I'm so happy about that. But yeah, that's kind of the health plan. For blush, I use this type of brush. And for blush today, I'm going to use my Hourglass palette. And I always mix like that purpley kind of golden shade, this shade and that shade. And I just kind of literally go wipe off the excess and then work it into the apples and pull it back. It's actually so pretty. I love it, blush lake. And then just to blend it all out, I will go back and just add a bit of the bronzy colour back in, just to make sure that it's not too overpowering with contour. Throw that everywhere. And then, so I'll take like a brush, fan brush, or else I love to use brushes that are just small, kind of like that. There's a hair on it. Like that, and I'm gonna go into my little MAC. This is the Cheeky Volume 1 Mixtape Jeremy Scott Collection from MAC. I just take this colour highlight. I'm gonna put that on the apples of my cheeks. They're like cheekbones. How stunning. Drag it down the nose. It's so pretty. I even like throw it on my hot forehead. Like, who cares? Yeah. So now I'm gonna focus on under my eyes. On underneath with like a flat type of brush. This to just put as the first color. So yeah, hopefully you guys kind of understand my whole health kind of thing now, of like when I'm gonna be traveling back, that kind of thing. It's gonna be so soon. I cannot wait. Like, I'm just so excited to like go home and like eat the food I've always eaten, that kind of thing. It's like, it's little things, honestly. It's obviously the people, but it's also like I miss the food that I usually eat. I miss the places, I miss my home. I miss just even how strangers are. Like, they're so nice here, but like, do you know the way there's just like no place like home?
There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
I feel like we all talk so much about Ireland being so boring, but like when you're away from it, you really do appreciate it. So now I look like a panda, so I'm just gonna blend those a bit better. Gorgeous. Okay, so now I'm gonna go into my eyelashes. I'm gonna use the Essence Volume Stylist. Actually, I think I'm gonna curl my lashes beforehand. The difference that makes. Oh my god, does this not happen to everyone, how mascara gets on the lower lash? The struggle is real. And there's just a bit of mascara on. I'm not putting it on my lower lashes just because every time I do in this weather, it literally seeps down. So I'm just not gonna do that. Doesn't matter if I look weird. Don't really care. And then I'm gonna put on some Stila Caramello liquid lipstick. Such a nice like muted type color. Love it. And I of course just make my lips a bit bigger than they are because I just think it looks better. I would love to get my lips done. I was actually planning on doing that when I was like 16 or something, 17. I don't know what age it was, to be honest. I really wanted to get them done, but then I ended up getting sick and my playlists were always too low, so I'm not gonna go like overboard with it. I would just like to get probably 1 mil. I will eventually get them done. And then on top of that, I'm gonna put MAC Honey Love. Yeah, MAC Honey Love, my favorite lipstick of all time. Very similar to the lip. And yeah, I think that's it for my makeup. So, okay, we're moving on to hair now. I'm literally just going to brush it out first. Gonna throw a bit of the Beach Babe texturizing dry shampoo in it, work it throughout. This is like the only dry shampoo I find doesn't go like all gray in your hair, or like if it does, you're able to move it out. Do you know what I mean? Like it literally just gives it a lot of volume, which is great. And it smells delicious. Oh my God, it smells like coconuts. And then, so once it's all over the place like this, I will just grab my brush and I won't really brush, but like I'll gently just kind of get it on top of my head like this. Okay, and then once it's on top of my head, literally just grab it, kind of place it like that, twist, curl it around, and it's gonna look like you have absolutely nothing. Grab like a scrunchie, whatever you're gonna use. Pile all that hair in there. Somehow you're left with like a bun, and then I'm just gonna throw this on. Just kind of like that. And now we're gonna get my outfit.
So the dress I'm gonna wear is my Tommy Hilfiger one. It's actually a really nice length. It's just above my knee, and I like the length of it because, you know, you can pick up something you're not gonna worry about like dress going on with you. It's not like really short. I actually love the length of it. And then for my shoes, they are Tommy Hilfiger shoes as well. Then for jewelry, this is a Cancer necklace. Cause my star sign's Cancer. This is from Francesca's, I think, and then my earrings.
Their little heart earrings are from Tiffany & Co. I'm a very big Tiffany lover.
And so yeah.
How pretty are these flowers, by the way, that I got sent for my birthday? Oh my gosh. I just thought as well I would mention my favorite perfume at the moment. It's the Tiffany & Co. perfume. It's a really nice mature scent. Like, I got it at Christmas and I just love it. I feel like I'm kind of done with the really candy smelling scents and I'm just loving this one. It's very like mature, makes you feel like a woman. And so yeah, that's my get ready with me today. And yeah, I'll see you very soon, guys. Please like the video and thumbs it up if you liked it. And I'll see you very soon. Bye.